I didn't really have anyone growing up. Me and my sister endured a very difficult time back home during our childhood. Verbal abuse, some physical abuse. I was very depressed with the constant yelling, the constant beatings. When you don't really have, you know, that support, you know, it's very difficult to have that purpose, that wanting to live, you know, like you feel like you have nowhere to turn. What was I gonna do with my life? My parents were gonna support me. How was I gonna go to college? How was I ever gonna get ahead in life? I didn't really have a purpose in life. Why was I here? I was alone in this world. I didn't have anywhere to go. I couldn't handle it. When I went to high school, and they realized that I was very sick looking. Ms. LaPerche was with Women of Tomorrow. She was one of the first people who I could really open up to and just spill my heart out to. Women of Tomorrow, they changed my life. Seeing women who were doing so well in their life and open to hearing about what I was going through and not being judgmental was inspirational, and it gave me hope. I remember having a meeting with the girls one day, and Pam came in and told us EIL is offering a scholarship and they can go anywhere they want. I worked so hard on those essays and I interviewed at NBC Studios. I get a phone call and it's Bianca on the phone, and Bianca's like, guess what? And I'm like, what? And she's like, you got it, you got the scholarship. And I just started crying. That definitely shaped me from that moment on to today. I mean, I majored in Asian studies. I've lived in Japan. I've traveled many places because of it. You have that epiphany, you have that moment, and you think, without Women of Tomorrow, I don't know where I'd be today. I don't know if I'd be alive. I don't know if I'd be homeless. I don't know if I would have gone to college. So in a way, Women of Tomorrow did save my life.
My mentors changed my life.
You helped us to get the place to where we need to be. It's awesome.
I found love here. I find people that I can trust.
I can actually afford to go to college now.
Thank you very much for everything you've done. You know, you've changed my life.
Hello, Mommy. I got the scholarship. I got a lot of money. Now I can go to Emory.
If you want to affect a young girl's life, this is the way to do it. This is the best bang for the buck. Shulamit, you know, she was a physician by training, but she was really a humanitarian. And she really believed in helping people, not just by writing the check, but actually doing the legwork as well. My wife could have done whatever she wanted, but she chose to be a volunteer with Women of Tomorrow. This is one of those very worthy causes that we can actually help our own community help itself. You're actually starting a chain reaction that is everlasting.
Everybody's